Incremental greetings, this is Grand Palau, also known as William Palace. Today I'm going to share with you how I import ebooks on SuperMemo, especially using the Pandoc software. Because you can use, there are multiple ways you can use, that's my personal preference, especially when I want to keep lots of pictures with the book. So the book I'm going to use, for the example, is Room Forever. I'm using a dummy collection because I don't want that on my main collection. And that's because I'm already familiar with this book. But let's say that here I have the Kindle, right? So I have my legal copy. But if I want to convert this, I will have a hard time. So I won't cover this. You can easily Google how to do it. I will skip that just because of legal issues of copyright and this kind of thing. So you will end up with an EPUB. Here it is, runforever.epub. So the point is how you convert these into SuperMemo, right? So first thing you want to do is install the Pandoc. It's an open source project. You can convert many files. It's not limited to these two kind of files, EPUB and HTML. Feel free to install it on your computer. It's not limited to Windows. So if you're using SuperMemo on a virtual machine, you can install it on your own computer. So when you install it, the quickest way to do in Windows is here typing CMD as I did before and enter. Now you summon the command line and with your own very same folder. I will copy and paste because Pandoc, it's only, there's no UI, user interface, you have to use the command line. So here's the syntax. Pandoc, it's the name of the software. Now, the action of M and CSS false is to get rid of not all, but most of the styling on available on the EPUB. There's so much noise you can get rid of. Then S is for standalone. This means that you want everything in just one single file. And on Pandoc, that's not the default. So you need to do this to override it. Then the extract media. We will create a folder where all the picture will be going there because we need a full path in SuperMemo. So we are extracting before all the media files. And then the name of the book and the name of the resulting output file, which will be the same. You could put a different name, but for the sake of simplicity, I'll always use the same and will be HTML. And the O stands for output. So now what I will do is delete the space, so there's no issue with the software, and I will copy that as well. So I will changing book for Fluent Forever in this case. I could just rename the file to book and that will be the same. But if you want to convert more books, I will suggest to give a meaningful name. And here you go. So now press enter. As you can see here, now I have the folder and the HTML. So in the folder, images, here are all the images. Well, there are not so many. 122, but some of them are dummy. And here's the HTML, right? So I usually open on Firefox. That's my main browser. Good. As you can see, images are working. An optional step, just for the sake of making the splits a lot easier, is look how it's done. How is the structure? So here I have introduction, principles, and so on. So let me look at chapter. What's doing? Okay, it's H1. Cool. So what I will do, optional step, is getting rid of IDs and CSS classes. So I will open this file or note here with syntax highlighting. You can see you have classes and so on, right? So now, just for work more easily with SuperMemo, I want to get rid of these, the class and ID. For all H1, H2, and so on. But it's even easier to get rid of them all. So, search and replace, real expression. So what I want is class, in between, what's not quotation mark. Now it is in parentheses. And finally the counter. Let me put the pointer at the beginning and replace all. Now, as you can see, we need the ID. So it's as quick as changing class by ID. And once again, replace all, lock all the changes. There are more changes that we need to, and save. Good. So now the file is more clean. Now I go back to Firefox and refresh F5. Okay, and now it's more cleaner. What I do is Control A. I use it by copy and pasting. Go back to SuperMemo, make a new topic, and paste it here. Now you can see the pictures are working, but those are inline pictures. That's one huge caveat, is that first, if I delete this folder, pictures are gone, obviously. If I rename these, for instance, or I move, instead of downloads, I put on another hard drive or whatever, our pictures will be broken. And since I'm using a color coding, I already know what it is. That's H1, H2, and something like that. And usually there's some, you always have an index. Usually I do delete the index right away. So you can use delete after cursor, which is alt point. This will save me lots of splits. Now, depending on the book, it can, as you notice, that SuperMemo struggles a little. And now it's time to do the split. But before the split, what you want to do is setting the metadata. So that will be Alt Q, that will be the title, and Alt Q again, and author. Yeah, I made this styling with huge labels because I really want to be sure I don't forget. And now you can see here I have the metadata ready. Good. Next step, that depends on you. If you will keep all the folders on your computer for a very long time, as long as you need to process this, there's no issue. But what I will suggest is Control F8 and localize all the pictures. As you can see, there are some dummy and so on, but usually what you want to do is download them all, select them all, and localize. So you will have a local copy. Later on, when you make a ton with all the topics, you will get rid of unused pictures. So now if I go on the registry, you can see I have 122 images already. With another caveat is that the name are not descriptive. See, at least you can know it's from the same book, but for the name, you cannot see what's in the content. So if you are a hardcore user, what I suggest is that incrementally, when you use the pictures, you will be renaming them. So next step is the split. And even if you want to use heading 1 or 2, don't use that. Use the custom string. And H1. Little false positives, because I noticed that you have chapter 1 and then the actual chapter. But it's not a big deal. So you just select these. You can delete them when they are pop up in the standing, but I'm doing just for the sake of the video, so you can see everything here. I delete. Here you can see I have the second. The purple for me it's the second heading. So you will do that incrementally when this pops out, but for the sake of the video, once again. So now it's H2. And here it is, I have the five principles. I will just get done. And here we have principle 1, principle 2. Here you can change the priorities where you want to. Let me see that here, look. I will use that as an example because there are some pictures, right? So I will split this even further to the third level. Okay, and here what I suggest is to use the Control F8 Usually, you will use that, especially if you are from Wikipedia articles and so on. But once again, I remember the caveat. The folder is on downloads. So if I use Firefox and I wipe out my download folders, then everything is screwed, right? You could do these two and insert them as components. Nice. That's the way to go. I like this. This feels more incremental reading. Nice. And when you process them and you use extracts and so on, perhaps, and usually if it's a flashcard, you could rename that. It's okay. Let me look here. That's gibberish. If you want, you can leave this. So I know for sure that's from forever, or I can make my own convention, FF, whatever, and cat. Maybe that's not best example, but something like this that you don't want to find on online, because you can use any cat, right? It's okay. I will make an exit out of this. Oh, there are two here. Okay. Pressable 3. So what I will do is Control F8. Next time you see that, it's okay what it is. Okay, so I will rename, and for me that will be one forever, principle 3 bars or bar graph or whatever. So more descriptive. So I will extract that since it's using a citation. I guess that's from a readable source, right? So I make an extract now, and here I have the picture, but that's not useful. So that's the one I want. And you can do it here. It's okay, you don't remember how many matches per second a week. Let's pretend I want to remember that. And here is when I will use the rename. Do something meaningful. So I really suggest, especially if you're new to SuperMemo, is to make your own convention. There is no wrong and good. I have one, some of them are very cryptic, because it's useful for me. Because I know what to input when I want to look for that. This comes with practice. And that's all. So what you want to do is, let's say that pops out on the standing queue, and you do the same. You do the split with the second header. If it's long enough, you will do the third, and so on and so on. So in the knowledge tree, more or less, you will have a copy of how it is in the book. And then you will have your own extracts. So you will be adding even more layers to the book. And of those extracts, you can have more extracts within those extracts until you finish with the end product, which are flashcards.